shit's on me, baby.
Top Rank Incorporated, the Mandalay Bay Resort Casino Hotel of Las Vegas, Nevada, the Las Vegas Hilton, and your undisputed, undefeated King of Beers, Budweiser. This Bud's for You present 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC Welterweight Championship of the World. Sanctioned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission Chairman Dr. Elias Ghanem, Commissioners Glenn Carano, Lorenzo Fertitta, Dr. Luther Mack, and Dr. James Nave, Executive Director Mark Ratner, Chief Physician Dr. Flip Homansky, Physicians at Ringside Dr. James Wishgame, Dr. William Berliner, and Dr. Margaret Goodman. Timekeeper and counting for the knockdown seconds will be James Cavan and Mike Lachella. At ringside for the World Boxing Council, President Jose Suleiman. Supervisor for the WBC, Rex Walker. The three judges scoring this contest on a 10-point must system will be Carol Castellano, Chuck Giampa, and Jerry Roth. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action working for the 152nd time in a world title bout, Richard Steele. And now, from 60 square acres of the hottest and most exciting real estate here in Las Vegas, the Mandalay Bay Resort Casino, for the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black with white, and weighing in at 147 pounds. He enters the ring with a reputation as a masterful boxer and brings an outstanding professional record to back it, consisting of 48 victories, 28 by knockout with only 2 losses and 1 draw. Tonight, he plans to make the ultimate step in his career to shock the world and leave this ring as a champion. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your challenger from Detroit, Michigan, the number 4 ranked contender in the world, Oba Motor City Carr! And across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing blue and weighing in also at 147 pounds. In 1992, he captured Olympic gold, and now, as a professional, he has a perfect record. 30 bouts, 30 victories, including 24 knockouts, while earning 4 world titles and the recognition as, pound for pound, one of the best in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, from East LA, presenting the former junior lightweight world champion, former lightweight world champion, former super lightweight world champion, and now the reigning and defending undefeated WBC welterweight champion of the world, the Golden Boy, Oscar De La Hoya.
instruction in the dressing room. I'm cautioning again. Obey my commands at all times. I give one, two warnings. After that, points will be deducted. Shake hands. Good luck.
Bend in on his uppercut, okay? Right. Okay, don't bend in on it. In and out, side to side. Yeah, you lost the first round. So, but still, we ain't lost the war. We still in the fight. Put the S square right there.
Listen up.
Let's go! Tienes que pensar más que en este round, ¿ok? Un poquito. Usa más el jab, muévete un poquito más. Te comenzaste a quedar enfrente un poquito. Y ocupa más con el jab, ¿ok? Ocúpate con el jab. Ritmo, ritmo, relajado, relajado. Oscar, cada vez que lo rimas a las cuerdas, go to the body, al cuerpo, ¿ok? Jab, right and left to the body. Give me that combination.
Don't stand in front of him, ¿ok? Okay? Mm-hmm. Stay out of in front of him. And keep breaking on with that jab. You want to rest?
Yeah.
Follow the round. Good that round. You're doing, he's being first. As long as you're being first.
Oh, just want the right hand by itself. Move your right. Go right hand just to change it.
Hooks to the body and stepping around.
Let's go! your head.
And stay busy with a jab. Just move, move, keep moving. Don't stay still in the front. Oscar, dame combinaciones de dos golpes, dos, tres golpes, okay?
Come here, look at me.
Cuídale a la derecha. Oscar, tienes que ser primero. Primero, primero, primero. No te esperes tanto, no te esperes tanto, ¿ok? Vamos, vamos, trabaja, 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 ocúpalo.
He's a little higher now, I think, so you can use your jab.
Ya te está tirando la derecha muy descarado.
Okay. Yeah. Let's go, second.
Keep it on the side.
Watch your head. Time. Time. Turn your head. I told you to watch your head, okay? 1 point, headbutt.
Break!
Vamos a trabajar más, boxeo. ¿Cuántas combinaciones juntas, ok?
Keep in hell. Way up.
Vamos.
Jab going.
Keep that jab.
Breathe up. You in shape to fight all day. You in shape to fight all day, baby.
Go to the charm.
Get your arms up. Get your arms up.
They're giant.
Mas tres rounds más.
No, you're right.
Tres rounds más, okay? Boxeo.
Relax, no problem. No problem.
Is there a new one up?
Out.
Don't hold him. Break.
To my grace.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at the Mandalay Bay Resort Casino of Las Vegas, referee Richard Steele, following the knockdown, calls a halt to the bout at 55 seconds of round number 11. The winner and still the undefeated WBC welterweight champion of the world from East LA, the Golden Boy, Oscar De La Hoya.
Oscar.
Round of applause for the young man.
Oscar, congratulations on another victory. A little tougher than you thought it would be.
You know what? This guy, no, he can take a punch. He was ready. Like I said, every opponent I have, they lift themselves to the moon, to the sky. So he was ready. But it was a good fight.
In a number of rounds, he was simply beating you to the punch, and you seemed a little bit off-put until you established yourself. What was going on?
I was ready. I didn't feel tired. I didn't get tired. I felt very strong. But.
Do you feel you made the transition to being the kind of aggressive fighter that you said you wanted to be in this fight?
Oh, yeah. I pressed the fight in the first round. Second round, little personal problem that I had that I won't mention. But after that...
What was it? What is a problem you can't mention?
I would rather not, because I have an opponent, September 18th, Felix Trinidad. I'm going to get you. Come on, bring it on. We're going to fight. Let's do it.
Okay, I'll take your cue then. Why are you calling out Felix Trinidad? He should be calling you out, presumably. Why do you want him so badly?
Because we're going to fight September 18th. He finally signed the contract. Let's do it. That's my next fight, September 18th. We're going to do it, and I'm ready, and he's ready. It's going to be the fight of the century, I guarantee.
Were you measuring yourself against Trinidad in terms of his fight with Carr when he stopped Carr in the eighth round tonight?
After the second, third round, I couldn't do the things I wanted to do. A little personal problem that I kind of encountered.
You couldn't do the things you wanted to do. I mean, does it have something to do with your stomach?
No, just something something physical, yes, but I'd rather not mention it because it's kind of personal.
Kind of personal. Okay, I won't go any...
The low blows. That's
okay. All right. You were the low blows bothering you, actually?
No, no.
Because
no,
you didn't show any discomfort during the fight.
Nothing bothered me. Nothing. I was physically ready.
What about the butt? I mean, it was an accidental butt, but a point was taken away. Did it have any impact on you at all?
No. Not the headbutt, not the low blows. Nothing. He's a great fighter, good fighter, a good solid fighter.
Should we take anything out of the fact that in the last couple of rounds, you started to move your legs more, started to get a little distance, and then the knockout came?
Yeah, that's where the personal problems occurred. I had to use my legs more. You know, I kind of sensed he got tired. So, yeah, I did a kind of, not showboat, but kind of jump up and down and kind of counter him, you know, make him make mistakes. But either way, if this personal problem wouldn't occurred, he would have been out. Sorry.
All right, I'll leave it to other reporters to unearth that, and I'm sure they will. Fight you gave. Was the knockdown in the first round a two-point round, and the 2 points he took away from you later in the fight make you any more desperate as the fight went on, that you knew you had to knock him out?
First of all, I gotta thank God, the Lord Jesus Christ, for giving me the strength to just, you know, make it to the 11th round. But, you know, I could have been a little faster today and just, you know, worked off my lateral movement and my stick and my jab a little bit more, but...
You found him easy to hit in many rounds, didn't you?
I found him easy to hit, you know, but, you know, I think that, you know, I could have gotten the fight a little bit better with my jab, but, you know, he's a quick fighter, but I think that, you know, I could have just, you know, used a little bit more transition in the fight.
Thank you for a terrific fight. Just one question. Fans want to know your opinion of De La Hoya versus Trinidad. You've been in the ring with both of them.
I think it'll be a good fight. Both of them are fast fighters. De La Hoya is a little bit more evasive. I think that, you know, both fighters have to just be careful. They get caught. You know, they get dropped. You know, this is a tough business. So, you know, we got to just train and just do the best we can in there.
So you don't see from your perspective, which is the best perspective, that either one has any particular advantage?
Both of them is just astronomical fighters, and I can't take neither one of them for granted. So I really can't call it. You know, you just have to get in there, and just whoever's a tougher warrior that night will prevail.
Thank you very much, Oba. Jim.